Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'd. Ayyul habbati fillah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, Ad-deena nasiha. Ad-deena nasiha. Ad-deena nasiha. Qalu liman? Qala lillahi wa li kitabihi wa li rusulihi wa li a'immatu muslimin wa ammatihim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, the religion is sincere advice. The religion is sincere advice. The religion is sincere advice. And then it was said to him by the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, for who? And he said, for Allah, or to Allah. Wili kitabi, and to his book. Wili rusulihi. And his messengers, or to the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kama qala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa li a'immatu muslimin, and to the imams of the Muslims, wa ammatihim, and the general Muslims, letting us know that it is from the religion to give sincere advice, and that this is an act of ibadah, an act of worship, if it's done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to bring yourself up, not to belittle others, but for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in defending his religion. And may Allah bless us to be from those people who do that. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Ahabita fillah, it's imperative for us to look at this issue as it always comes up. People defending Yasir Qadhi, Dr. Qadhi, and defending Nouman Ali Khan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and guide them. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. However, ya habita fillah, the only reason that I feel it's necessary to speak about this again, and I don't spend my time thinking and following up their mistakes, but because their minhaj goes against kitabillah wa sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and their belittlement of aqidah. And if you want to look at all the questions that have been posed to the ulama of Ahl Sunnah with regards, especially Dr. Qadhi, the mistakes that he has made and the continual mistakes that he makes. And we're not just talking about light mistakes, we're talking about he has taken a manhaj, he's taken a methodology, غير سبيل المؤمنين, which is other than the سبيل المؤمنين. It's other than the path of the believers, meaning the path of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah. It's other than what the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in and the Salaf of this Ummah took as a path in his way of calling to Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ahabita fillah, is it from Islam to refute one another? Is it from Islam to give advice to one another? Of course it is. And this, when you refute, it should be done with knowledge, based upon knowledge. And it should not be done based upon desires. And it should be a means of defending the religion of Islam, defending the Ammatul Muslimin, as we found in the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you're defending the creed of Ahl Sunnah, you're defending the minhaj, the methodology of Ahl Sunnah, from deviance, from newly innovated matters, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith of Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, qala rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu furad, whoever innovates in this affair of ours, we have it rejected. Wa fi riwayah li Muslim, and in the narration of Muslim, man amala amalan laysa alayhi amruna furad, whoever innovates in this affair of ours will have it rejected. Because these types of acts, when someone deviates in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with regards to creed, with regards to methodology and calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a new form of dawah, which was goes against what the Salaf laid down as qawaid, principles in calling to Allah, or even a fiqh, a type of fiqh which asserts that it's better than what the Salaf of this Ummah and the whole history of Islam has codified. Meaning the ulama, generation after generation after generation, have had ijma on various masail, and then someone to come now and say, la, that ijma, غير معتبر, is not something that should be considered or something that's beneficial, but rather, I have a new opinion. وَعِيَاذٍ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ أَحَبَتِ فِي اللَّهِ. Did the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in practice this minhaj of refuting? Na'am. Did the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-khawarij kilab an-nar, that the khawarij, they're the dogs of the hellfire. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَقَالَ لِي أَبِي ذَرْ إِنَّكَ أَمْرُ فِيكُمْ جَاهِلِيَّةً متفقون عليه in Sahih Muslim wa Bukhari. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi, he said to Abi Dhar, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, verily you have within you an affair of jahiliyyah. You have something from jahiliyyah left with you. This is a refutation. This is based on ilm that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had of this act of racism that Abu Dhar, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in, he had mentioned something to Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhum, saying that you are the son of a black mother, or as he said, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't accept this. And he refuted him, letting him know that this is not from Islam. This is from the days of ignorance, this racism. Wa qala alayhi salatu wa salam, amma ma'awiya fa sa'luka la ma'lahu wa amma abu jaham. فَالضَّرَّابٌ لِلنِّسَاءِ مُتَفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. This is a hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as for Muawiyah, that basically he is not, he's cheap, so to speak, for a lack of words. This is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And as for Abu Jaham, because he was giving advice, this is the deen of nasiha, as we said, giving advice to the women about who to marry. And as for Abu Jaham, that he is severe in, you know, beating the women. He basically is a woman beater, or he is someone who is hard on the women. Ahabati fillah, is that not from Deen al-Nasiha? Of course it is. And in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وقالت هند للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أبا سفيان رجل شحيح متفق عليه. هند رضي الله تعالى عنها, she said to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, she said, verily Abu Sufyan is a man who is stingy. And the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين, they used to refute one another. Because refuting someone does not mean they're an innovator. But refuting a mistake is an obligation. You cannot, even if it's a great imam of Ahl Sunnah, but he makes a mistake in an issue, even if it is someone beloved to you, even if it's your father, you have to correct them. You have to invite them to that which is better, especially if they're an authority giving dawah, calling people to Allah, because the people will accept what they have to say and they could lead the people astray. That's why it's imperative to correct one another and refute one another based on knowledge, not based on desires. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, لَأَنْ أَفْتَيْتُ بِمِثْلَ مَا أَفْتَى بِهِ أَبُو مُوسَى لَكَدْ ضَلَلْتُ وَأَضَلَلْتُ رُوَهُ بُخَارِي. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, he said, if I had made a fatwa like the fatwa that Abu Musa made, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, then I would have been misguided and I would have misguided others. That's a rad ilmi.